I've now laid out our 2 1-meter quadrats, 1 3 meters north of plot center, 1 3 meters south of plot center. And before I switch cameras to give you a better view of that, I'm just going to walk around our plot and identify all of the species that we have found in here. So I'm going to do my best on the Latin. If I make any mistakes, don't judge me. Red huckleberry, Vaccinium parvifolium. I see deer fern, Blechnum spicant. Sword fern, Polysticum munitum. Trailing blackberry, that's Rubus ursinus. These don't count, but I see some hemlock seedlings. I see some salal, Gaultheria, shallon. More huckleberry, more deer fern, more sword fern. Oh, I see some, this might be just a touch. I can't remember if this was inside our plot or not. I'll mention it. Western starflower, which is, I know northern starflower is Trientalis borealis. I can't remember western starflower. Trientalis is the genus, though, so you can look that one up. More western starflower. Wall lettuce, which I don't remember the scientific name. That's an exotic species. Oh, and we also have some English holly, which is, I think, Ilex aquifolium. Don't quote me on that one. That's another exotic species. Here's a good native shrub, salmonberry, Rubus spectabilis. Yeah, nice salmonberry here. We've got some other ferns here. We have some brackens, or bracken ferns, which is Pteridium aqualinum, and Pteridium is with a silent P. I see some spiny wood ferns, Dryopterus, I think Dryopterus spinosa. Double check me on that one. I'm feeling a little rusty today. I actually see some fruit of the trailing blackberry over here. Lots of trailing blackberry. Oh, I haven't touched the mosses yet. I have seen a fair amount of Oregon beaked moss. One scientific name is Kinbergia oregana, or oreganum. I think Kinbergia oregana. And there's another scientific name for it with a different genus. So plenty of Oregon beaked moss. A little bit of wavy-leaved cotton moss, or flat moss. That's Plagiothecium undulatum is the scientific name of that. So there's quite a bit of that over here. And I'm mostly seeing things I've already mentioned. Trailing blackberry seems to be one of the main ground cover plants around here. More western starflower. Obviously there's a fair number of sword ferns. More salmonberry. Fair amount of red huckleberry mixed in. And I think I saw one more moss somewhere. Oh, here we go. Yep, here is some step moss. Oh, I'm drawing a blank on step moss. Oh, it's going to come to me. Step moss or stair step moss. It's a Hylocomium splendens. That's step moss or stair step moss. Okay, I think that's all of the... I might have missed something, but I think the species that I listed probably cover at least 95% of what is in our larger plot.
I didn't give you the percent cover of those species, but now that you have an idea of the species that were in this plot, take a look at the vegetation summary table for this subzone. This is coastal western hemlock, dry maritime. Take a look at the vegetation summary table, look at the plants that are on your list, and look at the table and see if you can narrow down which site series you think we're in. You might be able to narrow it down to one site series or maybe two site series.